Hello students, today we are going to do class 6 integers. So today is my part 1 for class 6. Class 7 already I have done 3 videos on this. If you want to go through, there you will get more detailed concept, little more in class 7. So here we just take the basic thing, what is required for your chapter, and we will do exercise 3A. So very first thing what we have is, what are integers? So first part, if you see, I'll teach you the concept. When I rub this, then I will go to the exercise 3A and I'll try to do most variety of the question, so that you have a very clear understanding of the concept. So first I'll teach you what are integers, how we represent them. See Roman big 2, you can see Arabic numerical 1, 2, Roman 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 most important concept I have taken out from this chapter. So later on you can pause the video and write in your fair copy. Classwork copy. So very first thing children, an integer consists of the negative of all natural numbers. So these are natural number 1, 2, 3, 4. So negative of all natural number 1, negative is minus 1. Natural number is 2, negative of natural number 2 is minus 2. Like that. So these are negative of all natural number. 0. 0 is here, negative of natural number, 0, and all the counting on natural number. So integers consist of 3 things, 1, 2, 3. And this is how we represent it on a number line. We start with 0, left side it goes towards minus infinity, this goes towards the right side of positive infinity. Third thing we see, what is absolute value? If you want to see, you have a little bit more discussion there in class 7 video, you will see. So here absolute value means sometime we are not interested in only numbers. So what we do, we take the numerical value. Later on I'll explain it to you when I do the sum. We are interested in the numerical value regardless of its sign. So even this sign is called, absolute value is also called modulus, and in short we call mod. Okay, so mod of minus 6 is 6. So negative becomes positive, positive is positive, and 0 is 0. Once more, this will be new for you. Mod of a negative is also positive. This is second example. Positive remains a positive in the third example, and fourth example, mod of 0 is 0. Fourth thing we see, use of integers as directed numbers. So sometime we go beyond maths in our daily life and we see if profit is plus. So while doing question 1, we will see this concept, profit is plus, then loss is minus. If you go towards, if you are doing geography, you will know this is your north, east, west, and this is south. See, going towards east is positive, coming back towards west is negative. Going north is positive, going south is negative. Height above sea level is positive, below is negative. So this concept more we will see later on also. And the last concept is, when comparing two negative integers, the one with smaller absolute value, numerical value will be large. So one which is smaller, you know one thing, 7 is bigger than 3, but children, minus 3 is bigger than minus 7. Once more, you know 3 is less than 7, 3 is less than 7, or 7 is more than 3. But the negative side, just the opposite is true. Minus 3 is greater than minus 7. Here I have given you another example. 3 is greater than 1. 3 is greater than 1. But one small thing you remember, which I'll discuss, in this number line, if you go towards the right ones are bigger than the left ones. So, right ones are bigger, left ones are smaller. So, 3 is to the right of 1. 3 is to the right of 1. So, 3 is greater. This mouth open means greater. Mouth open means greater. 3 is greater than 1. Opposite here, if you see minus 1 and 3, this minus 1 is to the right of minus 3. So, minus 1 is greater than minus 3. So, you can pause the video, write whatever nicely in your fair copy, and now I am going to start your exercise 3A. So, please pause the video, I am giving you time, and recapitulate what I have said and try to remember them, because each one of them are very, very important. So, we start the chapter by doing question 1. What you will see in question 1, children, there you will see opposite, like the fourth concept what I taught. So, we will see application of the fourth concept in question 1. So, we have the very first question, only few questions I'll do. Question 1, part 1. This is called, you write the opposite. So, opposite is, so first question, gain of rupees 90. What will be opposite, boys? Gain, I told you, is plus. It will be loss of rupees 90. So, opposite of gain is loss. Second, or in fact third one, I'm trying to do the odd number. 200 meter due, that means in the direction west. So, answer is 200 meter due east. So, same way, if you see somebody is below average, if somebody is below average, so here the keywords were west and east, so it is above average. So, like this, we have question 1. Question 2, we have indicate using negative sign, indicate using negative sign. So, the very first one is an increase of 8 and increase of 8. So, it will be a decrease of minus 8. So, once you change increase to decrease, you will have to understand this. So, this will also change. Okay. Then, second, spend, third, spending of rupees 725. So, it will become saving of minus rupees 725. So, see, in this full question, I am not doing all. Spending becomes saving. Once, just opposite concept you take. So, opposite of plus is minus. So, same way, children, you try all the question, pause the video and write, and all other question, From your any text you have, you can practice and check your answer. So next I move on to question number 3, which is write all integers between all integers between 3 and 10. So question 3, I have to write all integers. So the very first question is between 3 and 10. So what I'll advise you, you draw a number line. So draw a number line and you start with, suppose here, 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, write all integers between. All integers between word is very important. So between means between 3 and 10. So our answer is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Okay. Number 3 is minus 7 and 0. So same way you draw, and here we start take one extra to this side. Minus 7, minus 6, minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, minus 7 and 0. 0, 1. So what is my answer? Minus 6. Between this, leave to this 2. Leave to this 2. So same way any other question, children, you can do like this as I have done for you. Okay, then question 3 this was. Question 4 is write 7 integers greater than minus 6. 7 integer greater than minus 6. So beyond this side, same question I am explaining. 7 integers greater this, I told you right ones are greater. But it's anything this side, any answer you take. But what will I do? What we should take? Greater than minus 6. Here. So, minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 1. 7 integers. 7 integers greater than minus 6. And then, question number 5 we have, children. You have to say which is greater. So I told you, explanation all I cannot write. Positive or greater than negative. Okay, next. I have minus 8, minus 14. In negative 1, my last note, smaller the absolute value, bigger is the integer. So generally what do we see? You see 14 is more than 8. Mouth open means 14 is more. But here what we have opposite. This side is mouth open. Minus 8 is bigger. Because you see minus 8 is here. Minus 14 is here. This is towards the right. So next one. Number 5. 15. And minus 15, which is greater? Positive is greater. Plus 15 will be this side, minus 15 will be this side. Plus 15 is to the right. Number 7. 9 minus 1. Definitely 9 is positive greater. Next. minus 9 minus 1. So as I told you, which one is greater, one which is less in value, mouth will be opened towards the right, minus 1 greater. This side you read, minus 9 is less than minus 1. This side you read, minus 1 is greater than. Here you read less than, mouth is closed. Mouth open greater than, mouth closed less than. Minus 9 is less than minus 1. Minus 1 is greater than minus 9. So here I have done 4 questions and 5th question, and here I will please pause the video and write clearly both the question and the answer. So now I will go to question number 6. So please, you just don't see maths. Children, this is not movies or serials. This is study. So maths, you need book and copy. If you have no book also, you can write in your copy, because I am writing the question. So you can understand, even if you have a different textbook, but generally the pattern, the idea is same. So if you understand the concept, then there is no problem in doing any question from any book. So question 6 is about absolute value. Okay, so here we learn some very important, what I taught you, absolute value modulus. So here I'll do all the 4 sum to make your concept clear. 6 part 1. We have to find the value of this. So as I taught you, minus value in absolute is becomes plus. So plus remains plus, minus becomes plus. So this gives you 9. But you will have understanding that why this is happening. I'll give you one example. You know, in geography, this is east, this is west, north, south. So if a child goes from here, from 0 towards east, we call it he has gone plus 3. I told you this direction is taken as plus, this direction is taken as minus. Suppose next day he goes towards the other direction. He comes here, through this side. So there is something called distance and displacement in physics. So he goes here, 3 km distance is traveling. Here also is traveling 3 km distance. Okay, so sine minus 3 means here he has walked. So we write maybe he has gone minus 3. That is in the opposite direction, but ultimately you see we never walk somewhere in minus. Minus here means in the opposite direction. So this side plus 3, this side minus 3. But absolute value, children, absolute means he has walked 3 km. Minus means this side. You go above somewhere plus, go down minus. If I have money, it is plus 50. If I give, it becomes minus. Same will, gain is plus, loss is minus. So as I explained, so don't worry about minus. Minus means suppose you walk 17 km towards this side. What will happen? So minus 17 is this side. Ultimately you are walking 17 km. Distance minus means in opposite direction, nothing else. So minus 17 becomes 17 and positive remains positive. So this is called absolute value. Second sum we have, third sum in fact, minus 9 plus mod of minus 9 plus mod of 6. So as I told you, inside mod negative becomes positive, same way with this. So we get 15. Part 4 I'm doing, this is not 5, part 4, minus 23 minus 12. So this is 23. See, this minus is outside, this remains. Inside minus changes, inside minus changes, outside remains. So this is 11. Last one, it has three pair. Now see this, minus 6 mod. So finally, the last question, mod of minus 6 is 6, plus comes here. Outside sign you don't change. Mod allows you to change only the inside sign. Minus becomes plus, minus 5 becomes plus. Outside sign children don't take. So what we have? 6 plus 1, 7 minus 5 is 2. So this was all about our modulus question. Now, few increasing and decreasing order question we have. So, three more questions we will do. So, you must have paused the video and tried to copy. So, one sum you can try. I will do from increasing and decreasing order. And the last one for today's session is about question 7, ascending order. Okay, so very first question is 14 minus 7 minus 13, 0, 6 minus 2, 30. So children, ascending means less 2 more. This is like climbing a hill. So we arrange in the order. Ascending means small. Smallest is minus 13. Minus 7. Put a tick mark. You will know we have written it. Minus 2, 0, 6, 14, 30. Okay. So minus 13, minus 7, minus 2, minus 11, 0, 6, 14, 30. Alright, same thing we go and do. So see, minus 13, minus 6, minus 2, 0, 6. Then after that we have 14 and 30. You can understand in a number line. If you have any problem, you draw a number line. Minus 13, then slowly you will come to minus 7, then you come, you will get minus 2, then you will get minus 1, 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, like this you will reach 6, then finally you will reach 14, then 30. So, ascending order go from left to right. Smaller, left side are smaller, right side are bigger. So, same way question 8 I will do descending. So descending, we have opposite from more to less. Okay, so question 1, so you can write here ascending order. Descending order. 8 part 1, minus 16. Minus 21, 8, 0, minus 7, 14. So which is the biggest? The biggest number you see is 14. Big to small. Then 8. Then 0. Then minus 7, minus 16, minus 21. So please copy. This big to small. This is big to small. So if you number line, we see we come towards left. Big to small. 14. Here you will have 8. You will have 0. You move towards left. Okay, minus 7. Then you will have minus 16. Then you will have minus 21. Why I'm putting dots? Because there are number in between them. I have not plotted all because of paucity of time. So hence we go to the last question and we try to do representation on a number line, few things. So please pause the video and copy and we move on to the very last question of this exercise 3A, that is number 9. So number 9, we have to represent on a number line. So just I'll show you two more parts of number 9 and we will finish the today's session. So number 9 part 1, represent on a number line. So we have -3, 2, 3. So if you see -3 to 3, so it will be not between, the word between is not there. So these all numbers you have to plot. So take a number line and what you do, -5, -4, -3, -2, -1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This side I take one extra. So darken them. -5, -4. Represent on a number line all this. So we darken means we know we are talking about these integers. Okay. So up to 3 only. Up to 3 only. So one last question I'll do is part 3. Question is represent on a number line non-negative integers less than 6. Non-negative integers less than 6. So what will be the answer? Non-negative means you can take 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these are the integers which are less than 6 and they are non-negative. See, 0 is neither negative nor positive. 0 is neither negative nor positive. So if you represent them on a number line, last question, 0, let us have -1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So represent them, darken them. So these are integers less than 6, non-negative. Here these are less than 6, but they are negative. So I hope you have understood the concept and the sum. Please copy all, try to understand, and any book you have, any textbook, if your idea is there, I know 100% you can solve the exercise, and any problem, please go through the solved example in the book. They are very good to give you an idea, concept, solved example and unsolved example, and finally check whatever you have done with the answer, so you will learn a lot of things. Thank you boys for watching.